Hey guys, welcome to the guide for 1-4. This is a fairly short level which only has 3 skips to learn and not much else to it. The skips do have a lot of time save however, so they are very impactful to the run. This means that you'll probably have to practice level a lot, so bear that in mind. The first skip is a standard transition skip. First, drop in Sala and whip the platform as Indy. Meanwhile, jump to the ladder with Sala. This is quite an awkward angle and is quite precise, so try not to wiggle as much as possible. Then grab the torch with Sala by pushing the statue. Jump into the snake pit and jump across with Indy. Make your way back to the ladder with Sala and go towards the right hand side button. Then turn off V-Sync and drop out player 2. Walk through the transition as Indy. Walk back through as Sala and line them up with a crack between the left and middle slabs. Then switch to Indy and punch Sala 4 times. Then walk very slightly towards him and he should be pushed through the transition. If you're on console, it's important to know that this glitch won't work, but there is a different technique. All that's different is that you need the ice rink extra turned on. That's it. This means you have to buy it from the store in the hub at some point in the run before you do this level, or any level with transition skips. It only costs 15,000 studs, so if you have a couple of extra levels before this one, you should have accumulated the studs to buy it. Then after Sala's through the wall, if you got the transition skip first or second try, you can just keep going. But if you didn't, grab the torch with Indy and throw it at a steep angle through the transition and try and make it to hit you as Sala. Okay, now everyone's in the same place. As Sala, run towards the orange button and as you go over the edge, loop back around to land on the Ooble layer. Then run back to the snake pit and try to get level with the floor of it. There is a slight inclination as you approach, so try not to overjump. Stay tight to the corner, as if you go too wide, you fall into the abyss. Then follow the wall, making sure you don't go through it. Then jump twice after your icon passes the statue on the right, and it should make you hit the transition into the next room. It might take you a few tries to perfect this route, but eventually you won't miss it. This skip is quite complicated and there's several parts to it, but it saves more than 3.5 minutes, so there's no excuse not to learn it. Now once you're through, swap to Indy and turn V-Sync back on. Now jump along the bars and whip across the gap. Break the cobweb. Quick dig the lever. Then pull on it and jump to the rope on the right hand side. Then move the camera away from Marion and drop her in as she appears on the screen. Then wait for both of the ropes to reach the bottom and drop down with one of the players and walk through the door. Now the next room requires some more complicated 1P2C. Walk to the right with both players and with Indy dig up the cog and as Marion break the pots. Then punch two of the bugs and pick up the key. You should then have the cog by now, so start moving up and left with Indy. Grab the second cog with Marion and follow Indy up and left. Place the two cogs in their respective slots and jump over to the platform with Indy. Then start turning the key with Marion until the platform reaches this hieroglyph here. Then you should be able to jump up to the top with Indy and Marion, and if Indy gets stuck on this snake, punch it with player 2 and keep on moving to the buttons. This room isn't worth talking about, just take a straight line and don't die to the final spike. And here is the room that might make or break your run. This skip saves around 1 minute and 20 seconds instead of doing the fight, so it's definitely worth attempting 2 or 3 times before you fully reset at first. So this is technically a strat split, and here's the logo over some blurred gameplay. As Indy, whip across and place yourself in the top right of the pit. Once you've lined yourself up, quick dig the bars, and as the digging animation finishes and the completion noise plays, switch to Marion and jump on the rope. Then as you jump off, moving the camera up helps but isn't necessary. Walk across to the right and jump onto the lower platform, keeping a fairly wide line, and watch the bar at the top of the screen for Indy to walk. Be ready to switch as sometimes you only have a small window to do so. Structure is exactly the same, however, as you enter the room, drop in Marion and walk to the right with her and wait about 3/4 along the platform. After Indy completes the dig and the sound plays, drop him out and follow the same steps as before. This saves around 2 to 3 seconds compared to the strat, but I'd recommend practicing the first one before attempting the second one to begin with. This will help you learn the timings of the glitch before you overcomplicate it. Then as Indy jumps the rope, climb to the top, and you can then do a long jump onto the bar at the bottom, then you can double jump up to the top, jump across to the platform, and push the brick, and you're done. As I said in the last episode, this one was going to be slightly shorter than the previous guides, and this level does not have too much content to it. The skips it does have, however, are very impactful, so definitely don't write this level off as easy. Ah, finally.